IBP only runs in the cloud, and particularly the SAP cloud. When you contract IBP, SAP gives you two tenants, the dev test tenant and another one, which is the production where your planning will happen when you are live. At the same time, SAP provides you with a link to the CPI for the integrations between IBP and your other ERP systems like S4 or ECC. As soon as you contract IBP for one of the functional modules, SAP delivers you with the platform. The platform is a group of features that allows you to operate IBP smoothly, like batch job management, like analytics, like dashboarding, like configuration capabilities, like integrations, like I said before, with CPIDS. So the platform is a given as soon as you've got one of the modules of IBP. SAP IBP runs with HANA. Utilizing HANA provides a high level of performance when calculating background jobs like optimizer, heuristics, heuristics propagation, forecast, forecast consumptions, and any other operator running in IBP. Important. So in the cloud and with HANA. First modules in IBP, SNOP. It is obviously designed to cover the SNOP process with the many reviews like demand review, supply review, new product introduction review, capacity review, possibly financial review, followed by a simulation step, so-called pre-SOP simulation, where you carry the what-if scenario options in order to find element of solution to be provided to the last step of the SNOP. The MBR meeting, Management Business Review meeting, where the top management will take decision based on what you have simulated ahead and take the good decisions. Not only that, but also SNOP provides you capabilities to define, to model your work process, defining your demand planning process, your supply planning process, your SNOP process as well. A process being made of steps, and each step is being made of tasks, and tasks being assigned to assignees. Next, demand. Demand allows you to create your demand planning from the mid to long term forecast, and as well with a specific focus on the short term with demand sensing. So in the normal demand planning constructions, you go with forecast from basic to advanced to very advanced statistical model, then combined together with marketing inputs, sales forecast input, demand planner inputs, customer input if any, and then ending with the consensus demand plan construction with formulas to create the selectively which data belongs to the consensus demand plan. That too ends with the so-called mid to long term forecast. And this other part of demand is demand sensing, which allows you in the very short terms to auto adapt, to sniff, if I can say, the demand evolution in the very short term and see how does it fit with the mid to long term forecast and possibly take actions. So this is the demand modules. Third modules, IBP response and supply. It's a bizarre module made of two technology, time series on one end and order-based planning on the other end. Time series for the tactical planning, very comparable to SNOP, except that in supply, you have advanced operator like optimizer, heuristics propagation, finite heuristics options, which you don't have in SNOP module. And then order-based planning in IBP response and supply. Order-based planning to cover constraint forecast calculation, also prepare allocations for advanced ATP, and also do some simulation more focused on the short term, in order to have ideas about the feasibility of such demand out of the current plan. Order-based and time series, there will be a dedicated episode to explain what's the technology difference between those two ones. Fourth, inventory. Inventory. The name is a bit misleading. It's nothing with inventory management. It's in fact a smart way to calculate your safety stock using an optimizer going over a multi-echelon method on one end, and also to better understand the compositions of your stocks, like what is my stock? Is it a pipe stock? Is it a ordering stock? Is it a safety stock? Is it excess stock? Is it whatever? So you will segment your stocks and better understand your stock. And once you do that, you can nicely calculate your safety stock quantities against your network. Next, DDMRP. DDMRP was designed by Camelot initially as an extension to IBP. And then later, SAP adopted these modules to become the standard and official DDMRP proposition in IBP, according to a partnership between our two companies. Last for today, Supply Chain Control Tower. It's not a functional module, it's more like added features, reporting features, and alerting features, which allows you an extended visibility on your supply chain, as well as capabilities to better follow the expediting of issues against your supply chain. This is it for today. Now you have a broad view of what IBP can do for you, for your company.